Hello friends, I am your friend Takshir Yadav in a series of the last three lectures on the topic rational numbers. This is the fourth lecture and in this lecture we are going to discuss about the distributive property of multiplication over addition and subtraction. So let's start. In today's topic, that is distributive property, as we know already that to study any property or any other thing in mathematics, we must first know its basics and the formulas. So let's start. What is distributive property? As suggested by the name, distributive. Distributive comes from the word distribute. And what does the word distribute means? The word distribute means to divide something between two persons or among more than two persons or anyone else. So here in the case of mathematics, distributive property refers to any two numbers whose sum or subtraction is multiplied by another third number. So as we can derive from the statement, the formula is, suppose our first number is A and A is multiplied with the sum of the second number B and the third number C. So when we solve this formula, we get A B plus A C. Here A is divided among both numbers B and C, or we can say A is multiplied by both numbers and their multiplication is added, as B plus C into A can also be written as AB plus AC. We shall understand it with the help of an example. I take the value of A as 3, value of B as 4 and value of C as 5. Okay? And on this side we again put the formula 3 into 4 plus 4 into plus 3 into 5, sorry, because it's A into C, not B into C. We have 3 into 5. Okay, now when we solve both LHS, LHS is the left hand side and RHS is right hand side. This is LHS and this is RHS. Okay, now let's solve the both sides. We get 3 into 4 plus 5. 4 plus 5 is 9 and 9 into 3 is 27. On the LHS, thus we get the result as 27. Now comes the RHS side. What about the RHS? Here we have 3 into 4, that is 12, plus 3 into 5, that is 15. 12 plus 15 is equal to 27. As we can see, LHS and RHS both have the same results. Thus, we can conclude that this formula is correct. Now comes the second formula, that is of distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. This was over addition and now we are going to discuss about the distributive property of multiplication over subtraction. So here we go with the formula, that is A first integer multiplied by B second integer minus C third integer. Again when we solve this formula, we get AB minus AC. Okay, we'll check this formula by using the same values. Earlier we took the value of A as 3, B as 4 and C as 5. We'll put the same values here. We get 3 into 4 minus 5. Okay, and on the RHS we have 3 into 4 minus 3 into 5. Done. Now 4 minus 5 is equal to minus 1 and minus 1 into 3 is minus 3. When we have two different signs, the signs are multiplied on one side and the numbers are multiplied on the other side. Minus into positive, negative into positive gives us negative, and 3 into 1 is 3. Thus our answer on LHS is minus 3, and on the RHS we have 12 minus 15. That is also equal to minus 3. Hence we conclude that both sides are equal, and due to this result we come to know another thing, that this formula is also correct. Now we'll discuss this property for the four types of numbers, that are whole numbers, integers, natural numbers and rational numbers, about which I have already told you in the first lecture. Now let's discuss about them. First we'll take the whole numbers for testing. Here I'll take the value of a as 2, b as 3 and c as 5. Now for the property of distributivity, property of multiplication or addition, these are the values and this is the formula. We put the values in the formula and we get 2 into 3 plus 5. This is the LHS, and on the RHS we have AB plus AC. So 2 into 3 plus 3 into 5, that is B into C. Sorry, we don't have to take B into C, we have to take A into C. So we'll take 2 into 5. 2 into 5. In solving these equations on the LHS, we get 2 into 5 plus 3, that is 8. 2 into 8 is equal to 16. This is the LHS solution. On the RHS, we get 2 into 3, that is 6. And 6 plus 2 into 5, that is 10. 6 plus 10, which is also equal to 16. LHS and RHS both have the same solution. Thus, verify that whole numbers are distributive in case of multiplication over addition. Now comes the second formula, that is distributivity of whole numbers in multiplication over subtraction. In subtraction, we have A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. Putting these values again, we get 2 into 3 minus 5 on the LHS, and on the RHS, as per the equation, we get A into B, 2 into 3, 2 into 3 minus A into C, 2 into 5. 2 into 5. 2 into 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5 is minus 2, and minus 2 into 2 is minus 4. This is the solution of the LHS. On the RHS, we have 2 into 3, 6. 6 minus 2 into 5, 10. 6 minus 10. And when we solve the RHS, we get minus 4. The solutions on both LHS and RHS are equal. Hence, whole numbers are distributive in the case of multiplication over addition and both subtraction. Now comes the second type of numbers, that is integers. We'll take the same values of A and B, and the formula is also same here. Now a question might arise in your mind, that what about natural numbers? We have already discussed that the properties of natural numbers are same of that of whole numbers. Thus we do not have the need to discuss the properties of distributivity of multiplication or addition and subtraction on natural numbers. So we'll just discuss this property of integers and rational numbers. Now we have the topic of integers. In integers, we again take the formula. Yes, and I change the value a bit. Minus 2 and minus 5. Done. Now let's put the values in the formula. We get A into B plus C, that is minus 2 as per the values, into 3 plus C, that is minus 5. minus 5 should be equal to, we will put double bracket, double parenthesis here, and on the RHS, this was the LHS, on the RHS we have AB plus AC. A is minus 2, hence minus 2 into B, that is 3, added to AC. A is minus 2 and C is minus 5. We get minus 2 into minus 5. Done. One more parenthesis. On the LHS, when we solve, we get 3 minus 5. Minus negative and positive when multiplied, negative and positive signs when multiplied give the negative signs. Hence 3 minus 5. 3 minus 5, that is minus 2, and minus 2 into minus 2. Negative into negative, we get minus 2 into minus 2. Negative negative signs together make positive, and 2 into 2 is 4. Hence on LHS we have the answer positive 4 or simply 4. Now comes the RHS. On RHS we have minus 6. 3 into 2 is 6, and positive negative signs together give negative. So minus 6 plus we have, and minus 2 into minus 5. Negative negative signs together give positive, and 5 into 2 10. We get minus 6 plus 10. Minus 6 is smaller than 10, so the sign of the solution will be positive, and 10 minus 6 is 4. So positive 4 is the solution on the equation of RHS. Positive 4, both are equal. Thus concluded that integers are distributive in the case of multiplication over addition. Now comes the formula of distributivity of multiplication or subtraction in integers. In integers, in subtraction, we'll just change the signs. We get minus 2, we get minus 2, 3, minus 5 on the LHS, and on the RHS we get a into b minus 2 into 3 minus a into c, that is minus 2 into minus 5, minus 2 into minus 5. Yes, a into b minus c, and a into b minus a into c. We calculate this. Minus 2, this is the LHS and this is the RHS. This is 3 and this is minus 5. We multiply both signs, negative and negative, they together give positive. So 3 plus 5 is 8, and 8 into minus 2, negative 2. This is on the LHS, and on the RHS we have minus 2 into 3, that is minus 6. Minus, we have minus 2 into minus 5, negative, negative, positive, and 5 into 2, 10. Minus 10. 8 into negative 2 gives us negative 16 on the LHS, as positive and negative together give negative sign. And negative, negative, both signs are same, but in this case we are actually adding. We have positive 10, and here we have negative 6. So positive, negative, negative. Thus we have minus 6 minus 10, which gives us minus 16. On the LHS we have minus 2 into 8, that gives us minus 16. Minus 16 and minus 16 both are equal. Thus you conclude that integers are distributive in the case of multiplication or subtraction. Now comes the last type of numbers, that is rational numbers. It is rational numbers. What are rational numbers? These numbers are the numbers which can be expressed in the form of P by Q, where Q is strictly not equal to 0. We'll change the values of A, B and C in this case. But what's a number? Our numbers are rational numbers. We have rational numbers. Now value of A, I'll take value of A as 1 by 2, value of B as 3 by 2, and value of C as 5 by 2. when we put these values in this formula, distributivity of multiplication over addition, we get A is equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into B plus C. B is 3 by 2 plus C, that is 5 by 2. And on the RHS we have AB plus AC. AB is A into B, 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. Here this is AB added to AC. 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. 1 by 2 into 5 by 2. Done. When we solve these equations on the LHS, we get 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2 is equal to 8 by 2. 8 by 2 into 1 by 2. 2 will cancel 8 at 4, and 4 will be cancelled by 2 at 2. And 2 into 1 is 2. So the answer on LHS is 2. Now comes the RHS. On RHS we have 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. Thus we get the answer as 3 by 4 added to 1 by 2 into 5 by 2, that is 5 by 4. 5 by 4. 5 plus 3 is 8, and so 8 by 4, and 8 by 4 can be cancelled to get 2. 2 and 2 both are equal. Thus rational numbers are distributive in the case of multiplication over addition. Multiplication over addition. Now comes multiplication. Distributivity property of multiplication or subtraction. In subtraction we have the formula as A into B minus C. We put the value of A, 1 by 2, into B minus C, 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2. We have should be equal to A into B minus A into C. 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 minus, this is A into B, and A into C is 1 by 2 into C, 5 by 2. 5 by 2. We get 3 by 2 minus 5 by 2 is minus 2 by 2. On cancelling minus 2 and 2 we get minus 1. So 1 by 2 into minus 1 on the LHS, and on the RHS we have 1 by 2 into 3 by 2, that gives us 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2 into 5 by 2, that is 5 by 4. We get minus 1 into minus 1, that is minus 1 by 2. And here we get minus 2 by 4. 3 minus 5 is minus 2, and minus 2 divided by 4, which can be cancelled to get minus 1 by 2. Both results on the LHS and RHS are same. Thus rational numbers are distributive in the case of multiplication over subtraction. So friends, in this video we discussed the property of distributivity in multiplication or addition and subtraction over the different types of numbers, that are whole numbers, natural numbers, integers and rational numbers. Thank you friends for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my YouTube channel Takshila Love.